In an important judgment today, a Justice A.M. Khanwilkar-led bench set aside the Madhya Pradesh High Court order which had granted bail to an accused in a sexual harassment case and had asked the accused to get a rakhi tied by the victim in this case. 9 lawyers had challenged the particular High Court order in the Supreme Court and had also sought direction so that there was no trivialization of sexual offences on part of the lower judiciary. The judgment read out by Justice Ravindra Bhat stated that the appeal was allowed and that the court has issued certain detailed guidelines as to how such cases of bail needs to be dealt by the lower judiciary. The 2-judge bench has today laid down 7 guidelines which the lower judiciary has to keep in mind while they deal with such cases and such bail petitions. Bail conditions should not mandate, require or permit contact between the accused and the victim. Such conditions should seek to protect the complainant from any further harassment by the accused. Where circumstances exist for the court to believe that there might be a potential threat of harassment of the victim, or upon apprehension expressed after calling for reports from the police, the nature of protection shall be separately considered and appropriate order made, in addition to a direction to the accused not to make any contact with the victim. Bail conditions and orders should avoid reflecting stereotypical or patriarchal notions about women and their place in society, and must strictly be in accordance with the requirements of the Criminal Procedure Code. In other words, discussion about the dress, behavior or past conduct or morals of the prosecutrix should not enter the verdict granting bail. In all cases where bail is granted, the complainant should immediately be informed that the accused has been granted bail and the copy of the bail order made over to him or her within 2 days. The courts, while adjudicating cases involving gender-related crimes, should not suggest or entertain any notions towards compromises between the prosecutrix and the accused to get married, suggest or mandate mediation between the accused and the survivor, or any form of compromise as it is beyond their powers and jurisdiction. Sensitivity should be displayed at all times by the judges, who should ensure that there is no traumatization of the prosecutrix during the proceedings or anything said during the arguments. And lastly, judges especially should not use any words spoken or written that would undermine or shake the confidence of the survivor in the fairness or impartiality of the court.
Well, a division bench of the Kerala High Court in February had ruled that teachers of aided schools falls under the category of office of profit and that they cannot take part in political activities or contest for polls. Well, this particular order was challenged in the Supreme Court and a Chief Justice of India, S.A. Bobde-led bench, today stayed this particular order and issued a notice to the state of Kerala. Senior Advocate V. Giri, appearing for one of the appellants in the case, argued that the nomination date are closing in and that it is tomorrow and that this order of the Kerala High Court needs to be stayed. Chief Justice of India, S.A. Bobde-led bench, today heard mentioning by Advocate Prashant Bhushan, who urged the court to hear his applications filed in the electoral bonds case and in the Rohingya deportation matter expeditiously. Advocate Bhushan primarily argued that with the upcoming assembly elections and with the sale window of electoral bonds opening from 1st of April, it was pertinent that the court hears the electoral bond issue, especially given that the Election Commission itself, in one of its reports, has stated that electoral bonds was a means to divert funds to shell companies. After this, Advocate Bhushan also said that the Jammu administration was illegally detaining Rohingyas in the state and they were to be soon deported to the military government of Myanmar where they face genocide. Chief Justice of India, S.A. Bobde, stated that the Rohingya matter would be taken up next Thursday. Well, Supreme Court today stayed an order by a Telangana trial court which had passed an order directing the Major General of Indian Army and the Defence Estate Officer to serve imprisonment of 2 months at a city civil prison. The case in question is of a land dispute which dates back to 1976, wherein the Army asserts control over a portion of the land where the defendants say that they were in possession of the land since generations. Solicitor General Tushar Mehta apprised the court that the Telangana High Court had refused to intervene in the matter even though it was stated that such a drastic order was passed against the Major General of Indian Army. The Supreme Court bench today granted an ad interim stay against the order passed in the execution proceedings.
The Supreme Court of India today primarily heard three distinct petitions on a similar issue. Serum Institute of India and Bharat Biotech had filed their individual transfer petitions, seeking to transfer the Suomotu writ petition initiated in the Delhi High Court, which ventured into the question of how much vaccine can these two producers or manufacturers make, and if at all the lawyers community can be given a preference over others for the COVID-19 vaccines. This particular petition sought priority for the members of the judiciary for the COVID-19 vaccines. The Chief Justice of India, S.A. Bobade, today transferred the Suomotu writ petition continuing in the Delhi High Court to the Supreme Court and stayed all proceedings therein. It also issued notice on the two transfer petitions filed by Serum Institute and Bharat Biotech. The Chief Justice of India observed that the concerns of the lawyer community about having these vaccines was genuine, since they come in close contact for continuing their profession. When the Solicitor General suggested that this could also apply to other professions like a vegetable vendor or a journalist, the CJI went a step ahead and said that he wasn't sure that if journalists actually worked in while coming in close contact with the people, and that they could function even remotely. A Chief Justice of India, S.A. Bobade-led bench today asked the central government to challenge the particular bail order in which bail was granted to Riya Chakraborty in October 2020 by the Bombay High Court, and not only challenge the observations made therein. The central government had moved the Supreme Court challenging certain observations made by the Bombay High Court regarding the NDPS Act, and the Solicitor General argued in the Supreme Court that such observations could render the NDPS Act meaningless. However, the Chief Justice of India observed that it could only entertain a petition if the bail order is challenged and not only the observations. To this, the Solicitor General sought permission to amend the petition and challenge the bail order also. The case is likely to be taken up next Monday. Well, lastly, today was the day 4 of the Maratha reservation hearing, where a 5-judge constitution bench of the Supreme Court, headed by Justice Ashok Bhushan, was hearing a batch of petitions challenging the validity of the Maharashtra State SEBC Act, wherein educational and employment opportunities is to be given to the Marathas on quota. Attorney General for India K.K. Venugopal, while making submissions, stated that it was inconceivable that amendments could be brought in so that no states in the future could identify their own lists for the socially and educationally backward classes. Attorney General for India submitted that the rights of the states which remain untouched expressly by amendment will continue. He pointed to the opening remarks of Section 336, unless the context otherwise requires. There are public service undertakings in the Government of India, even offices of central government in states where there is employment of the public servants of the union. In these cases, the union won't take lists of state governments. Article 324A exclusively deals with the central government's competence to identify socially and educationally backward classes for its own purposes, wherein states, central government jobs or educational seats are to be filled up. They have to have their own list, argued the Attorney General for India.
Well, that's all from Supreme Court today. Do stay tuned with Supreme Court today tomorrow as well. And don't forget to like and share BharatBench.com.